Despite the fact that last year's financial report shows a slight increase of coffee production, which now stands at 4.4 million bags, government's dream of producing 20 million bags by 2030 is something researchers are still pondering about.
Meaning, out of every 100 seedlings that were being given out to farmers, only 42 were surviving, and 58 were, we shall not do the mathematics or the financials, but it may not be very, very good.
Addressing farmers who turned up at a 2-day coffee expo held in Imbarara, field officers hinted on what is frustrating coffee farmers in the region.
Any timely delivery of the seedlings to farmers as a result of poor coordination of stakeholders involved. So the seedlings could reach farmers late. Lack of skills among farmers in planting the seedling and managing it. So a farmer receives the seedling, he has no skill in managing it and planting it, and in the end, the thing it dries.
Our soils are no longer fertile. That's the fact. So before they supply those seedlings, they should first understand whether the soils we have can support the growth of coffee.
It was also revealed that farmers who have taken coffee farming as an enterprise are still earning peanuts due to middlemen.
We expect farmers not to be cheated, so we want the middleman to, we can't deal away with the middleman, but we want to decrease, or the farmers to have the knowledge, to have the information, because lack of that information is what makes these middlemen cheat these farmers.
The 2-day coffee expo concluded with government urged to focus more on value addition. This report was filed by Halson Kagure for Urban TV.